Dr. William Depp, Director General, ICRISAT, my senior colleagues, Mr. Kaushik Mukherjee, Mr. Shankarlinga Gowda, Dr. S.A. Patil, Mr. Chandrasekhar, Dr. Peter Crawford, Dr. Vani, Mr. Sarvesh, Dr. Krishnappa, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. When I was asked by Dr. Vani and Dr. Krishnappa to come to ICRISAT and to be participating in this, they said, we have the honor to request you to give the inaugural address, I thought I will be speaking in the beginning of this inaugural function. Now, I find, unlike the development commissioner, Mr. Kaushik Mukherjee, whose pen drive was taken by Dr. Vani, this distinguished audience on the distinguished speakers on the stage have taken my entire presentation away, because whatever I had planned to say will be a repetition, because everything has been covered in one form and another. So I think I'll have to throw my prepared presentation out of the door. There is no window around. Out of the door, and concentrate on a few random thoughts. Number one, let me submit to this distinguished audience that it's a matter of honor and privilege for me. We are making history. See, traditionally, last 50 years, agriculture has been the Achilles heel of Karnataka. The compounded rate of growth of agriculture has been around 2%. Now, there are various reasons for it. 10 agroclimatic zones, etc. And you have got fragmentation of holdings. Average size of the holding is 1.5 acres, etc. Therefore, issues of profitability, issues of sustainability arise. And all these factors put together have ensured that agriculture was really what was pulling down the progress of Karnataka, if you talk about GDP growth, GSDP growth. It's a matter of great pride for all of us that in the last 5 years, we have been able to achieve a rate of growth of 5.8% in agriculture over the last 4 years, which I believe is history in the making. And I believe that this is been almost entirely due to two efforts which we have done. It is focus on Bhuchetana and focus on horticulture, both of which we have involved ICRISAT. Now, everybody knows that ICRISAT is an organization which is synonymous with excellence. ICRISAT is an organization which is a world leader when it comes to, coming out with new and innovative technologies. But I think the sea change which has occurred now is, for the first time, we have looked at methods whereby we are not talking in terms of 100 acres, 200 farmers, etc. We are talking in terms of 3.4 million farmers, we are talking in terms of the whole of state of Karnataka, we are talking in terms of 6 to 7 compounded rate of growth. If you have been able to achieve 5.8% growth in 4 years, out of which 2.5 years has been drought prone, I leave it to your imagination what we would be able to achieve if we had been able to have good rainfall as expected. So ICRISAT itself, I think, has, their strategy has changed. ICRISAT has been here from 1972. Why is it that it has taken 40 years for them also? And I think I will take this opportunity to congratulate the visionary leadership of Dr. William Dar. I will say visionary because he is not only a scientist of international repute, but he brings with him a vision which is not found in many people. He is an extraordinary human being and an extraordinary individual. He has been a minister of agriculture in the Philippines. So he brings with him a vision, he brings with him, you know, the need to look at it from the other person's shoes, namely the farmer's shoes. He brings with him the need for looking at issues such as inclusion. What can we do for the small man? What can we do for the real hero of this, the farmer, namely the person who is unsung, unwept, who is struggling to make two ends meet? And therefore I think it is his leadership and his dynamism which has played a huge role in the success of the Bhuchetana experiment. The second, I think, you know, obviously I would like to take this opportunity of congratulating the Development Commissioner, Dr. S. A. Patil, Principal Secretary of Agriculture, and all the very, very dedicated, you know, officers of the Department of Agriculture, Mr. Chandrasekhar, Dr. Sarvesh, and of course, you know, Dr. Krishnappa and Dr. Vani. I consider them as our own people, you know, on deputation to ICRISAT, as other than the other way around, because, you know, that is what is called by partnership. You see, this is a test of partnership. We are partners. We are learning together. We are exploring new avenues. I think, you know, so this is a test of partnership, and this is something, you know, which I would congratulate all the, you know, the distinguished members of the team who are here. It is basically your success. Having said this, now what does the future, you know, what does the future hold for us? I think the first thing we should look at is this issue of sustainability, because there are still major challenges so far as Karnataka is concerned. Number one, 10 agroclimatic zones, small farmers, you know, 78 lakh holdings. I have already mentioned that. But I think, you know, if you take into account the national figures, Karnataka is lower than national figures so far as pulses, oil seeds and cotton is concerned. So whereas pulses, which contribute about 25% of Karnataka's area, as against a national average of 624 kgs, we are somewhere in the region of 454 kgs. In case of oil seeds, it's more pronounced. National average about 1000 kgs per hectare, we are somewhere around 504 or thereabout. 500. Then in case of cotton also, as against 412, it is 284 or thereabout. So these are areas, and I very specifically mentioned pulses and oil seeds, because when we talk about pulses and oil seeds, they are the really the things which add value, nutritional value to the poor man's food. And therefore, if we are not able to, you know, make the breakthroughs in these sectors, there is going to be an inevitable impact on nutrition. Therefore, now ICRISAT, I think, is very well endowed. They have got a huge platform for plant breeding, etc. They are well renowned for that. The challenge really is how to translate that into millions of acres of farmlands, not only in Karnataka, through the rest of the country, in fact, rest of Asia and sub-Saharan Africa, because that is a real, you know, challenge for ICRISAT. Couple of months back, when I had the opportunity, I was discussing with my senior colleagues, Development Commissioner, Principal Secretary, Agriculture and Horticulture. I asked them, in fact, we took a very interesting experiment with which ICRISAT has been, you know, intimately involved. In the horticulture department, we said, can we identify 50, you know, success stories? And can we tabulate all of them in a manual book? And maybe we can draw some conclusions. And what has been prepared by ICRISAT is an eye-opener. ICRISAT has prepared this book and Horticulture Department has published that. And some of the conclusions which can be drawn is all these 50 people whom they have selected are small farmers. Each one of them owns about 2 to 3 acres. All of them are earning annually about 2 to 2.5 lakh rupees per year. All of them have got drip irrigation. All of them are, you know, into organic farming. and all, most of them are doing subsidiary occupations like beekeeping and all that, which has enhanced, pollination efficiencies, etc. Now, this is a thing which gives us great confidence and hope that there is hope for the small farmer. Can we have a system, a technological, package which will assure income of at least 100,000 rupees a year, 1 lakh a year, so that a family of 5 can live comfortably. You know, that this I think is one of the next challenges when we talk about Chetana 2. Now, I was going to talk about, some of the research challenges which I perceive. I shall refrain from doing so I am not going to mention things about what is it that we are looking for yields and what is it we are looking for duration and drought resistant and pest resistant and better grain quality and nutritional status, improved nitrogen fixation. These are all the breeders are constantly working upon doing molecular, manipulation with molecular markers, etc. I am not so confident about pest control, etc., because that's an area which will take quite some effort. My own feeling is, particularly in pulses and oil seeds, etc., when we talk about pod borer and bollworm, etc., so I somehow feel that the longevity of these, these pests is so much, and their adaptability, if they have been around for 300 million years, their adaptability is so enormous that I don't think we'll be able to achieve something in the next 50-60 years. But having said that, there is a large amount of traditional knowledge which is available, not only in India, probably in the entire Asia, and these are some of the things which I would expect this Bhuchetana, the second phase, which we are now talking about Bhuchetana 2, to examine. I will share with you a small incident which happened 30 years, which I told my close friends. This is about 30 years back when I was, really green behind my ears. In a taluka called Sagar in Karnataka, there was an attack of army worm. And army worm that was so savage that every day about 20,000 acres of crop, standing paddy crop, would be decimated without even a blade of grass. And the agriculture department was at their wits end, 3 times spraying malathion, dust, etc., etc. Nothing would yield results. Ultimately, one of the then senior officers of agriculture department, who managed to travel in a bus to Shimoga, was sitting next to an old farmer who was a treasure house of information about practices. And this farmer got talking to the senior officer. Incidentally, after some time, this farmer was telling him that the most ignorant department in government is agriculture department, because they think they know everything. And then he asked him, incidentally, are you from agriculture department? So this person said, no, I am not from agriculture department. Then the farmer said, okay, then I'll talk to you. And he went on, he told him a couple of things. Next day, when our senior officer went to the farm, he told the farmers, who were absolutely distraught, that to take some beaten rice, what in Kannada we call avalaki, and soak it in water and spread it around. And he said, then the farmer said, okay, we'll do that, but what next? How is it going to work? He said, I'll come back in the evening and we'll talk about it. When our officers went back in the evening, they got a treatment which is reserved for royalty, because the army worm had disappeared. And the scientific explanation which was given was the fact that that was a breeding season for young sparrows, and from a height, the mother sparrow, which is looking for proteinous food, sees this white thing on the ground. When it comes near the ground, it sees the army worm and gobbles it up. So in 8 hours, army worm vanished. And this was a clue given by that old man. See, these are systems. See, we call it integrated pest management. We call it, we have got other, strategies. We do mixed cropping, planting on the borders. We go in for panchagavya. We go in for use of neem extract. There are so many. See, these are cost effective. But the point I am trying to submit is that there is a lot of this native technology throughout Asia. throughout probably sub-Saharan Africa. I am not too familiar with sub-Saharan Africa, but probably I am sure it must be there. Therefore, these are some of the things which probably, you know, Bhu Chetana too would look at. There are other you know, things which I would, the other thing which I would like to mention is one of the areas where I feel we have been somewhat deficient is the area that adequate farm implements to ensure that a person with one or two people can handle a farm of 2 to 3 acres. Can we do farm implements, you know, can we work without bending so that our productivity of an individual on the farm increases 25-30%? Is it not something which we should invest? We have got, you know, opportunities in RKBY. Probably, but these are things I would probably, you know, request ICRISAT to look at. They can, you know, funding is not their problem. Let me tell you one thing. You know, India and Karnataka is no exception, is growing at 6-7%. Whereas 10 years back, I still remember, the state budget used to be less than 20,000 crores. Today it is 1,05,000. This year it is 1,17,000. And this is the case in most of the major states. Forget about city states, but major states in the country, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, most of these states, Punjab, Haryana, you know, money is really no problem. The problem, the issue is leadership, the issue is commitment, the issue is finding people with passion, issue is for function, working as a team. If today, ICRIS, you know, this Bhu Chetana has been a huge success to the extent that I think that today is a historic moment. It is due to the teamwork, it is due to partnership, it is due to the fact that every member of the team has been working with the same kind of persistence and passion that, you know, which is a prerequisite for all success. In the next phase, I think, you know, there are other management issues which we need to focus. In most government organizations, you know, in most government organizations, and government of Karnataka is no exception, that 20% of the people do 80% of the work. So it is this 20% who become most important. I think, you know, we should ensure that this 20 or 25% people who contribute to the bulk of the output, they are identified, they are empowered, they are, you know, motivated, they are mentored, and therefore there is a huge issue of capacity building. There are certain gaps, most of which have been addressed by the distinguished speakers before me. The emphasis on marketing, etc., emphasis on sustainability, I have already mentioned. So these are things. So in this, now it's again a historic day that we are having this government of Karnataka, you know, tie up with the CGIAR institutions. I think for this entirely we must thank Dr. William Dyer and his distinguished colleagues. It is their initiative and their efforts which has, you know, resulted in this. This will ensure that we take a more holistic view in the second phase. We talk about crop, tree, livestock synergies. Dr. Dar mentioned about giving more focus on animal husbandry, fisheries, etc. Apart from what he said, I think the development commissioner was spot on when he said forestry issues. Forestry should become a people's movement. Forestry should ensure the biomass was increased, because the whole trend of the future is cutting down costs, you know, generating biomass, generating, ensuring that we take up, you know, the organic method of cultivation. So these are issues. The missing gaps, marketing issues, our linkage with NIDEX, our initiatives which we have to take in the agricultural marketing. Fortunately, Principal Secretary Cooperation is here, and they have done some very innovative things in the last two, extremely innovative. Some of them are game changers, but we need to do it in a much bigger way in the next 5 years. That is a challenge, because to take this experiment to the next higher level, we should fill in the gaps. The expectations are so high, that, you know, we have to run to be stationary. Are we having achieved what we have achieved in Bhut Chetana? The next level, the policy makers, the citizens, the farmers themselves, their expectations are so high. So in this second phase of Bhut Chetana 2, we have to give a close attention to the missing gaps, you know, marketing, etc., which I'm sure we will be able to do. The last thing which I would like to, you know, mention, you know, is the fact that we need to have a very accurate method of measuring the outputs every year and use it for management decision making. And I think somewhere down the line, we should adopt this concept of balanced scorecard. Balanced scorecard is something which is used by most corporates throughout the world. It is a technique which has been, authored by professors from the Harvard Business School, professors like Dr. Robert Kaplan, etc. Now, the difference between balanced scorecard and other methods of, you know, measurement and management control is, balanced scorecard gives focus on what is the concerns of all stakeholders. It not only talks about corporate profitability, it talks about customer perspective, it talks about whether there is enough being done to improve the internal processes, it talks about whether enough is being done for innovation and creativity. It Bhut Chetana 2 is to, you know, exceed the expectations of Bhut Chetana 1. They have a mountain to climb, and that can only be done if the concerns of all the, you know, stakeholders are not only measured. It is not merely a measurement tool, it is a management strategy, so that people across the board at all levels ask the proper questions and they get answers from these proper questions. Namely, are we addressing the concerns of farmers? Is agriculture profitable, sustainable, etc.? You know, do we have a system whereby there is enough focus on innovation and creativity? Are we in a position to ensure that the internal processes are improved, etc.? I think the development commissioner was spot on when he said, you dump these subsidies. You see, agriculture department does move away from this culture of subsidies. Subsidies is like giving a person crutches to run, whereas he or she should be able to participate in an Olympic sprint. That is what we should be looking at. The sooner we dump these subsidies, the better it is, not only for the departments of agriculture and horticulture, but for the farmers of Karnataka, because they will be able to go world over. You take any sector, you take small scale industries. Now, it is subsidies is not the answer. Reservation, you know, of lists exclusively meant for small scale sector is not the answer. Access to technologies is the answer. Investment on infrastructure is the answer. Access to credit is the answer. So we should move away from this culture of subsidies, etc. And I think Bhut Chetana 1 has shown the way for doing that, and we should take this up, you know, once, you know, take this forward. So once again, you know, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. I feel this is a historic moment for all of us. 6% rate of growth, you know, in Karnataka in the next 5 years will ensure that Karnataka will move on to a different orbit. It will ensure that Karnataka will grow at the rate of 8-9% compounded over the next 10 years. The next 5 years of this partnership between ICRISAT and the government of Karnataka is going to be the most crucial. We should make the best. After 5 years, you know, then the whole thing will be settled, and I think we are on that takeoff trajectory. So next 5 years, in fact, we look forward to the enlightened, you know, research leadership of Dr. William Barr and his very dedicated and excellent colleagues at ICRISAT. We look forward to the kind of unstinted support which the senior colleagues from the Department of Agriculture have given. We look forward to the passion and persistence of the average extension worker in the Department of Agriculture, the officers of the Department of Agriculture, and most important of all, we look forward to the fact that all of us put together, you know, can we motivate the farmer? Can we take him to the next higher plane? Can we ensure we have a 6 to 7% rate of growth? Can we ensure that this will put a halt to this urbanization which is coming about? Can we ensure that this ensures there is a perceptible decrease in, you know, poverty in the state of Karnataka? Agriculture, as you know, though it contributes only 18% to the state GSDP, more than 60% of the state our population is involved in agriculture, and there cannot be a meaningful assault on poverty if we do not ensure that agricultural incomes grow, the incomes of individual farmers grow, and people start looking back, you know, again re-examining whether it is whether there is a need to go to urban areas, whether we can go back to the farms and take up agriculture, because that is more remunerative than coming on, you know, to the cities and trying to eke out a living in the cities. So I think that Bhu Chetana 2 and this initiative with Government of Karnataka and CGIAR is going to create create new history. It will enable us to overcome the challenges posed by climatic change, and I am very honored that I have been given this opportunity of sharing a few random thoughts with this distinguished audience. And I am sure that 5 years down the line, when ICRISAT again has this annual conference and then they are reviewing Bhu Chetana 2, they can look back with considerable pride that we have progressed and the state of Karnataka has gone from strength to strength in the field of agriculture. Thank you very much.